Hi, my name is Doan, and I like to listen to bug vibrations. So bugs communicate using vibrations. And they do this by rapidly moving their bodies on stems and leaves. Most insects actually use this type of communication system, while cicadas and crickets are the few exceptions that do not. They use airborne vibrations. So my bug of interest is the Paracilla. And this is a pest of pear, which is one of the many that use vibrational communication. And so they primarily use this to find and attract mates. So males will produce vibrational courtship songs to woo the females, which actually are species specific. And so when the females find this attractive, they'll produce their own vibrational song, and this establishes a duet. And so a duet is also kind of like a location beacon. So think of this as like Marco Polo. The males will sing, the females will respond, and then the males will walk towards the female. And this repeats until they find each other and they mate. And so their babies, as well as the adults, poop out this sugary substance called honeydew, which makes trees really, really sticky, and is the perfect environment for mold to grow, which makes the pear unmarketable, because who wants to buy a moldy pear? Well, if we can understand the underlying behavior and biology of this communication system, we can potentially develop a mating disruption tool. For example, females, well, if they can't sing their half of the song, then the males won't be able to find them. We can do this by playing back male songs to overwhelm them. Additionally, environmental factors can have a big impact on making these pest management tools, right? Well, specifically, I observed that males sound different in different temperatures. At warmer temperatures, they are high-pitched and sound faster. In lower temperatures, they are lower pitch and sound slower. But the cool thing is, at really, really hot temperatures and really, really cold temperatures, they are less likely to sing. So if we can find that window, that optimal range of temperature that they sing at, we can maximize our disruption to their communication system. And the bonus to using vibrations is that conventional farmers and organic growers can use this system to disrupt mating. And finally, because vibrational communication is so widespread in the insect world, we can translate this type of mating disruption tool to other pest systems. Thank you.